Today is our 33rd birthday. How sad is that? It's also our last ever show. I got into the Cure quite late, actually. I started off as a goth. Weren't called goths then, we were called futurists. And we had big baggy bowies that came up to here, like Simon Cowell. And pixie boots. And here I am now. Met a girl at school called Sue Potter. She was the RE teacher. Noah, bloody hell. She was the RE teacher's daughter. And she took me around her house one day and she played The Cure in Orange to me. And I was so disappointed. I took this song from there. It's probably the first time I heard his voice and thought, alright, it's a bit like Olives. First time, 6 months later, and Olive would be nice with this. It's called Strange Day. We'll be right back. on that same video was another song that became one of probably my pathway into the Cure, I guess. I used to dance to this at Rafe in London, which was like an underground club that you could only find if you'd met Hagrid and a few other people before it. Which eventually became the slime light because we got sick of being chucked out of squats. And Matt died 2 years ago, who runs the slime light. He's left quite a legacy there, a big pair of shoes to fill. But I've got a treat for you. This song is from The Head on the Door. And we have the original sax player with us tonight. Ron Howe. It's called A Night Like This. We'll be right back. good. You might have noticed I'm walking a bit funny. I've done my back in. My wife bought me a pair of yoga pants and it put me in a really awkward position. Electric film. Thank you very much. So I never got anywhere with Sue Potter. But I did go and see Mark and the Mambas in London. I was 14 and we sneaked onto a train. And I hid underneath, the girl was wearing a Victorian dress with one of those plastic trellis things underneath. And I hid under that and got into Brixton Academy. And on the way back, I had to hide in the toilet of the train all the way up to Stevenage. And my friend had to fake an epileptic fit when the inspector came. If you did that now, I'd get cancelled. This goes out to everyone. Over the last 32 years, 33 years now, jeez. And also, of course, it goes to the Führer and his band, The Cure. Thank you for supporting us for all these years. And letting us pretend to be The Cure. you. This one apparently goes out to Ray and Becky. It's been a weird old 32 years. This year we got recognised in Record Collector, and they did like a double page spread on us as a tribute band to The Cure, because we did a Cure special. They asked some very silly questions though, but we did get marked down as being the oldest tribute band and the ones who've all got their own hair. So you can always trust the press. But they did say to me, are you as good a guitarist as Robert Smith? And I was like, oh, come on, this is a ridiculous question. Robert Smith wrote Boys Don't Cry when he was 17. I could play it when I was 12. I think that says something. It's called The Walk. Thank you. Next song, who remembers youth clubs? Youth clubs. Table tennis. Pool. Disco. Disco is like where we used to go to listen to music, young people. And you could have a disco as well. Didn't have to go there, you could have a disco. But youth clubs were pretty much where you went either and got beaten up by the teachers again, out of uniform, or beaten up by the skinheads at the bus stop on the way to the youth club. It all stank of glue, and they're now probably living in Brighton, most of them anyway. And the Scar Boys would nick your 20p, it wasn't 20p, probably 5p then to play the pool table at school. The Scar Boys would nick that. And then the mods would protect you from the Scar Boys if you lent them your eyeliner. And if anyone remembers what the vicar was like, there's a bit on our website for anyone that needs to go and sort themselves out. It's called In Between Dunn. Thanks for coming out tonight, guys. It's been really fucked up, hasn't it, the last 3 years? We've got a Prime Minister that only pays 22% tax on millions. When we're getting 500 quid a month fucking electric bills for a three-bedroom house. COVID, the whole lot has been really shit. So thanks for spending the money tonight, guys. Thanks for coming to a venue that's managed to survive. I dreamed of playing this place ever since I was a goth. One of those special venues where you just, every time you came to Brighton, you're like, come on, can we please play? No, you're not big enough yet. Please can we play? Oh, you're not popular enough. Please. And we're here! And they're still going and pushing out live music. Please put your right hand in the air. So I do solemnly swear to go out and see real local bands and buy all their t-shirts and CDs, or Simon Cowell will never die. Support your local live music, guys. Tribute bands are keeping the places open. Let's go and put some fame kids into fame and get them there with their music and not stupid auditions. And please, thanks for coming out. Tonight playing Susie was Kerry. On bass, Sean.
Thank you.
go, Mr. Ron Howe. Thanks again for coming out, guys. We're going to try and squeeze these two songs in. So we're not going to say much more because we've got a strict curfew. So thanks for coming out, guys. And thanks for saying goodbye.